You struggle to get things done. You feel completely overwhelmed, and of the work that you're actually delivering, you don't feel like you have enough time to put into it to be proud of your work. And so you can work more hours, you can hire more staff, or you can find efficiencies. But no matter what you do, you have to get this fixed before you burn out or you simply give up. We all struggle to get stuff done. If you're an entrepreneur, if you're a business owner, then you are an idea person. You get excited by things. You really love to jump onto new things, and you're probably a starter. Most entrepreneurs are not finishers, they're starters. And if you are a starter, it means that every new thing that comes along looks shiny, it gets you excited, it seems to be the answer that you've been searching for, but meanwhile you're ignoring all those other things that aren't shiny anymore. They're a few weeks old or a few months old. They're not so exciting. So you find yourself in a situation where you have all of this work to do. You don't have enough time and you don't feel like you're getting anything done. You're not delivering on the things that you're started. And this gets more entrepreneurs into more trouble than anything else because it feels like we're busy. It feels like we're making progress. And yet 6 months have gone by, a year or two or three have gone by. The very things that will make a difference for your business, that will drive you forward every 3, 6, 9, 12 months, you have to focus on and you have to get done and you have to deliver. So how do we do this though, right? Every problem in our business is the business owner's problem. Every single problem with the staff is our problem. With the clients, it's our problem. It is your job, it is your responsibility to deal with everything, to worry about everything, and to wear a million hats. How in this situation could you possibly ever get things done? The answer actually comes from trying to do less. Not trying to do more, focusing your time and doing less in a shorter amount of time will create all kinds of creative ways for you to get the work done that you have to get done. So the idea is to limit work in progress. It's called a WIP limit, and it comes from the development system of Agile. So programmers and developers have been using different systems of Agile for a long time to force more work to get done with fewer resources in a shorter amount of time. One of these Agile systems is called Kanban. And in Kanban, you set work in progress limits because it forces you to have fewer projects on the go so you can do more work faster. Most of us think that if we can have a lot of different things on the go and multitask and keep all the different balls in the air by juggling everything, we're gonna get a lot more done. But the truth is, if you limit all the open projects and everything that you're working on to only a handful and only a few, you will actually knock them out a lot faster and your overall system efficiencies will go up. Okay, let me explain. So in the Kanban system, you can take your entire process of working on things, of delivering things on whatever it might be. Let's take a really easy example. Let's imagine that we have to go to McDonald's and order a meal. Right? So in the system of going to McDonald's and ordering a meal as a customer, you have to, arrive there, and you have to park, and you have to walk in, and you have to walk up to the counter, and you have to place your order, and you have to pay. So imagine in your work, in your business, in the things that you do for your responsibilities, you take a project and you just list out the steps. Now the secret of getting this to work is to understand that you are going to hit a roadblock. And that roadblock may be in your control or may be out of your control. And so let's imagine in this McDonald's example, me walking into the McDonald's and I hit a roadblock. The door is locked. I have a few options now. I can go around and try a different door. I can get in my car and go to a different McDonald's. But I have hit a roadblock. Now, in your business, you have this project that is on the go and you're working your way through it and then you hit a roadblock. Most people start a new project. Right? You want to be efficient. You want to have things on the go. You don't want to be wasting time. So you hit a roadblock and suddenly in your business, you have to wait a week or 2 weeks or 3 weeks for something to happen. So you put that project aside and you start something new. Perfect. So you've grabbed something and you've brought it in and you're going to work on that a little bit. Oh, but now that first project, suddenly that roadblock has become unblocked and now you have two projects on the go, right? And this happens multiple times per day, all day, every day, until you find yourself with 20 or 30 or 40 things on the go. Easily, if you listed out everything that you had to do, not your to-do list for today, but everything that you're thinking about in your business that you have to do, you could easily have 100 things that you're working on. Easily. So let's say that you're working with a client on a quote, right? You're trying to figure out what the pricing is for a quote, and you're going to eventually write a proposal for it. You start working away on it, you hit a roadblock. You don't have the information you need. So you stop working on that project and you go, huh, what should I work on now? And you bring in another project, writing a blog post. You're now have in the background on pause, you have the writing the quote, you're now working on a blog post. You decide that you're working on it and you're working on it. Suddenly someone walks into your office. And now they want to talk to you about another project that requires you to do some research. So you've put now the blog post on hold and you're now working on that. You have three things on the go. Let's say that a fourth or a fifth or a sixth thing is taking your attention and you said no to all of those things. You are not going to bring something new into your part of the process until you have pushed out one of those other things. And let's say that those other things that are waiting on standby are really pressing. Like they're really, really, really pressing. They need your attention. But you can't look at them. You can't look at them until you get that blog post done. Is that going to put pressure on you to write that blog post? To get it done right away so you can bring that new thing in? Or maybe that quote. Maybe you're going to call the client. Maybe you're going to drive to the client's office. Maybe you're going to meet with them. Maybe you're going to do assumptions on them. Maybe you're going to push that quote through and get it really locked down because you need to free up the space for that next thing to come in. This is how setting limits on how many open projects you have forces your focus and time into the things you currently have on the go so you can get more done efficiently in the overall system. And so if you commit to yourself to only have 5 or 10 or 3 things on the go at a time and someone comes to you and says, hey, they come to me and say, Mark, I need your help. And I go, I'd love to help you with that. Please send me an email as soon as I'm done this other thing. And I know that I really got to focus on that, but I have these other things that I'm working on. Rather than pausing these things to constantly chase and put out fires, I got to get one of these three things done so I can bring the new one in. That is how you can become more efficient. So for me, I constantly feel like I don't have enough time. I don't have enough time to give the attention that it needs to work on a project so I can actually be proud of it because I'm bouncing around so much. And it's weighing on us. It's weighing on you right now, the stress of knowing all those things that you have to do. So I actually took my team through agile training. What we did was we tracked our progress, right? We bring projects in, we would work on them, and then suddenly, we ran into a roadblock. So I can't move forward my project, but I still had my time in my day, and I could apply my time in my day to Michael's project. And so suddenly I can push his project forward. And he ran into a roadblock on his project, a different one, but he could apply it to mine or to Amina, and we could swarm and we could push things through because we're not allowed to bring things in until we're pushing things through. And so that's really what's key. It's, yeah, at a given step, there are fewer things on the go, but the overall efficiency of pulling projects through the process and applying everyone's focus on things makes the whole system far more efficient. You get stuff done and you can actually deliver on work you're proud of. So how can you get started? First, think about your process and list every single step in your process. So in the McDonald's example, I list off a whole bunch of steps of walking in and walking out and getting my food. But in your work, you know, if you're a writer, it'll be one thing. If you're in sales, it'll be another. If you're much more focused on team building or research or as a service, whatever it is, think about the steps within the projects that you work on. It could be 3 steps, it could be 10 steps. Think about those steps. Second, list out all the projects you have on the go. So just the act of listing these out and visually showing you what work is where will be illuminating to you. It should help you understand how you're helping drive projects forward and how you're hurting your company from delivering on work. And then the next thing is just to try it. Try at each step to set a limit. And you have no idea what the right limit is. It might be 2 things on the go in that step. Set a limit that feels uncomfortably tight and then try it. Try tracking what you're doing and how you're moving things forward and see what happens. Here's another way that setting WIP limits has helped me in the work that I do. So I sit down and work with clients through this process called brand strategy. We do a competitive analysis and it takes up a lot of our time. It's an 8-week process. Every week I'm spending 3 hours with the client, working through these different topics and learning about their business and looking at what's happening in the marketplace and all of this stuff. It's a huge research and strategy type process, but it takes 8 weeks. And so I love working on brand strategies with clients. It's like an exciting part of the process. It's so fresh, it's so new, but I know for our business and I know for myself, I can only do 3 of them overlapping at a time. Because if you think about the week and you think about the fact that I'm giving someone like, okay, every Tuesday morning for the next 8 weeks, then I give another client every Wednesday morning for the next 8 weeks, and I'm giving another client every Thursday morning, and then all the other work that I have to do around it. If someone came to me right now and said, Mark, I need to do a brand strategy, I would say, awesome. I cannot wait to do this with you. Yeah, let's get started. I can't start it for 5 more weeks. Because in 5 weeks, I'm done my Tuesday morning brand strategies and I will give you that Tuesday morning spot. I would love to have 10 brand strategies on the go, but here's what else I know. I just don't have the emotional capacity or the excitement to work on 10 of these projects at a time. I'll just be stretched way too thin. But for now, I have to set a limit on myself, because any more than 3 of these at a time, and I'm actually not giving my clients the experience they deserve. It just is what it is. Either they're willing to wait 5 weeks to work with me through this process. It's not that long. I can give them homework. I can help them prepare. I can get ready to get started with them. But either we do that or they go work with someone else. I mean, those are the options that they have. But for me, I know that I cannot handle any more than 3 of them right now. And this is the power of setting limits. Now, you may think I'm crazy, but if you want different results, you have to take a different approach. You can't keep doing the things that you've always been doing. So read up on WIP limits, do a bit of research, map out your current steps, and look at what your project flow is like. And don't be afraid to try new things. Set this in one area of your responsibilities or your business and do it for a few weeks. And then I dare you to come back to me and tell me it's not working. Even with this thing, I feel like I was f-ing all over the place. How do you transition to think big, be bold, say yes? All right, just end with that.
Yeah,
cool.
If growing and scaling your business by being better at sales and better at marketing, better at customer experience is important to you, be sure to check out this video right over here. And like always, subscribe to my channel, click on the bell icon, and get each video every day when it drops.